Good morning. To Vlogmas day 3. Today is December the 3rd. It is like 8 something in the morning. I just woke up about 30 minutes ago. Be on camera. And 9:30 for my wig edges. And it holds pretty good. I use this Fantasia Liquid Mousse Mega Holding Spritz Hairspray from the beauty supply store. Pretty basic hairspray. Just to get my edges together. And then I pull out my baby hair. And I need to flat iron it a little bit. So yeah, y'all. I am getting my head together for work, because like I said, I have to be on a meeting. And I'm definitely one of them people that work from home or wear their robes. Like, people on Facebook be making statuses like, you extra as hell if you walk around the house in a robe every day, and is and do, and who gonna check me by my robe, boo? Who gonna check me about my robe, boo? Nobody. Y'all just mad y'all ain't at home in your robe working. But anywho, y'all, that's just me checking in this morning, y'all. I posted vlogs or vlogmas 1 and 2 already. So again, this is day 3. I'm probably gonna check in with y'all as the day goes on. Because, again, your girl probably isn't doing much at all. If I do something, it won't be till the weekend. Because, of course, it's a work week. New face brush and products. And my face looking pretty good so far. I look alive. I look better. I don't look as sick. And my eyebrows still atrocious. So, I'm doing that later. Like I said, yesterday or last night, I'm doing that later. So I can have some content for today's vlog. Spray a little spritz on the baby hair so he can lay down. Boom. So yeah, y'all. Like I said, your girl is about to get ready for work. I'm already clocked in. I have to check a few emails. I have to send some emails. And yeah, that's just what my day will consist of. What's up, my YouTube babies? And your girl is finally off work. Wait till after work today to film me doing my eyebrows. So like I showed y'all yesterday, this is the eyebrow kit from a company called Nats. Easy Salon. After you wax your eyebrows, you use that. They give you instructions in a book. I mean, in the box. And then these are the wax strips. And then, as y'all can see, I know the words are backwards, but it's a middle brow, eyebrow, eyebrow, eyebrow. So basically, you just cut them off and they're like pre-wax strips. But it says to read the instructions prior to. So let's read what the instructions say, shall we? And skin shield powder. So I'm trying to figure out why they only gave me one, but whatever. I really want gum. And yeah, I'm gonna use these wax strips to see if I can do it. Open up the powder, and it's really powder. Yeah, it's really powder. Powder. So I'm gonna apply it right here. And above the brow. I don't know what this is gonna do. It says it's supposed to help
the wax stick to the hair better and not your actual skin. So we are going to see. Maybe I should have used the Q-tip, but whatever. I already got it on here. I just dust the excess off in a second. One packet, because you really don't need the whole pack unless you just got some bushy ass eyebrows. All right, now I'm just using my spoolie to dust the powder off my actual eyebrows that I don't want to touch. Okay, so again, here are the wax strips. Baby, I like the way the booty go. Let me make booty go. Okay, so this is what it looks like. I'm assuming this is the wax that's on the back. And then this is the pair of strips. So when you cut it in that area, in this area, basically this is where it will sit, like for the wax. We're gonna cut on the dotted lines for where we want the wax strips to be. So I'm finna cut all of these off. So one piece, two piece, that's one eyebrow. Then another two piece for the other eyebrow. And then one in the middle, and then you got the little scraps if you got any extra. My hair in the middle, I don't really have hair in the middle, but I'm gonna just try. Let's see. It says remove. We're gonna remove this from the adhesive. Okay, so this is the actual wrap strip itself. And then it says I'm gonna do my right side first. So it says use your index finger to smooth it out, and then it says with the direction of the growth. It barely pulled anything, child. Let's try again. Let's get a little closer. No, it's not that bad. But I don't think it did anything in the middle because I don't have anything. So we are going to remove it. What I'm going to do is, let's see if y'all can see what I'm doing. Place it like that. One, two, three. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. It worked, y'all. Look. I'm gonna go back in, try again with this bottom part. I tried to buy my own wax during COVID and that shit hurt. So I was like, maybe it was the wax, maybe I wasn't doing it right. And then I saw these and I'm like, let me try. Okay, one, two, three. Whoo! But it looked better. Okay. Period. But it looked like, y'all, it really pulling the hairs. Like that, it pulled a lot more that time. There we go. What the fuck? Yeah, my eyebrow was bushy. But look at this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm telling y'all, it pays to have patience and do your own shit, because really, who want to pay for shit? Not me, for real. Especially if I can do it myself, period. Okay, Jess. Okay, Jess. Okay. Let's try to do the top. And then, like I said, I'm going to do this one on the camera with y'all, and then I'm going to try to finish the rest off camera and just come back and let y'all see my results when I'm done. One, two, three. Woo. It don't hurt that bad, but yeah, they looking good already. Finished this. I got 15 minutes worth of footage, so this is really good. And I'm gonna come back and let y'all see what it look like. Some lip gloss on too, because I don't need y'all chopping me up. There we go. And then some lip plumping lipstick too. So what I'm gonna do is put it on and then see when I come back if y'all can tell the difference. So this is the before. And let's come back. We gonna see what's coming. Okay, y'all. So I'm back. And y'all, look at my brows. It look like somebody professionally did. And I also waxed my upper lip, which is why I have this little spot right here. But I am loving the results. I used some tweezers to just get the little hairs that I missed. Which isn't much, but you know, I am like loving the freaking results. Like, you can't tell me that I didn't go and pay my good little $7 to $10 to get my brows done. And then this is the white, which is like the oil that they put on your brows after you get finished, which is just like, it says a calming white, but it's just like a calming oil, I'm assuming. Wow, I'm just so shocked. So if y'all like, look at my eyebrows, like it looked like somebody got them professionally did, or like I got them professionally done and I didn't. And I think I'm about to be over this side part, y'all. I think I'm ready for a middle part. Put some plumping lip gloss on and my lips. Looks like I got fillers. So your girl will never get fillers, even though I wish I've always wanted like bigger lips. And the lip plumper I use is the Too Faced lip injection. Let me show y'all an up close of my brows. Ooh, 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 your girl did that. This year I lost my job. And it wasn't that I was ain't shit as worker or anything like that. It's just like, y'all know the economy that we in. And then I work in insurance. So working in insurance, like the insurance industry has gotten crazy to the point where people are just out here going without insurance because it's just too high, you know? And the reason why it's high is because people are going without insurance and then coming outside, driving like a bat out of hell and trying to figure out, well, why I gotta pay all this. But this year just been so crazy for me, and I've been trying to stay as positive as possible. One thing I could say that this year definitely taught me was, you know, self-love, self-care, just appreciating myself more and going hard for myself, because I'm the type of person that if I care about you, if I love you, like, I try to prove to you that life is better or going to be better for you, you know, like, even though I know that, I want my people to know that too. Sometimes I tend to lose myself because I be so focused on loving on those that I love that I don't return the love that I get. And then if I have or expect people to return that love to me and I don't get it, then it puts me like in a crazy space, because it's just like, I'm proving all this X, Y, and Z to you.
and why I can't get the same in return. Like, I know we all come from different backgrounds and that everybody doesn't think the same. Like, my story is not the same as somebody else's. Even people in our families, like, we can be related by blood and stuff, and we can still have like the same last names or just be related in general. And just because we related or lived under the same roof doesn't mean we gonna have the same walk of life. Like, and that's something that I realized, like, with losing my brother and just in life in general, you know, interacting with people and going through shit and just life lessons and trials and tribulations. I can say that I lived in the house with my brothers and my mom and my granny and my auntie, and that we all kind of experienced the same things. But when we walked out that front door, like, everything was different from all of us. All of us experienced different shit because we're all different ages. We're all at different points of our lives. And then that's how you just gotta look at everybody else. And another thing is common sense. Even though you would think that it's common, it's really not. You know, like, common sense, is it even really a thing? Is it even really something that, you know, like, people should have? Or is it something that people should know? And that's something that I've been questioning lately, is because it's like, to me, life should be simple, you know, like, everything should be XYZ, in my thoughts. But then that goes to show, like, even though my thoughts are like that, like, just because, you know, you want treat people the way you want to be treated and shit like that, again, no two people are alike. So what might be upsetting to me might not be upsetting to somebody else. Or what might be important to me may not be important to somebody else. This year was just a lesson on, you know, standing on my boundaries, appreciating myself more, loving on myself more, and doing things for myself that will make me happy and that'll make me feel good, because everybody else does that for them. So if I'm sitting over here and I just told my little brother this, you sitting over here trying to make sure that everybody else is good all the while, you over here losing yourself, you know? And that's for me too. Like, people don't realize, like, us strong people, although we carry a lot, and let me not even say us, I'm a person that has been through so much shit, like, from the time I was a kid to now, and I'm 31, finna be 32 years old. I tell my story to people because people will look at me and think that I'm stuck up, will think that I'm this and that and the third, but really, I'm just a regular ass bitch who just trying to get some money, period, you know? And it's just like, when I tell my story, I'm transparent because I want transparency. I want people to be open and honest with me, because I am a safe space. I feel like I'm a safe space for those that I talk to. And I want to feel like when I talk to somebody that I have a safe space too. That's why I require transparency. And that's why, as I've gotten older, I realized that transparency is major to me. Like, you can be honest, but transparency is deeper. Like, you're actually taking a step out of this world of what you appear to be and what you want people to see you as, and you're actually stepping into who you are and where you came from, and then you're allowing people to know who you are, and you're allowing people to know your story, to feel and understand why you may act the way you act, why you may think the way you think, why you may talk the way you talk. And a lot of people just be out here moving, not realizing that they are product of their environments, and that's why they act the way they do. Transparency in the play, it helps both, not only yourself, but you being able to converse with people easier, because you don't have to have like this facade for people to understand you, you know? That's just something that I've been working on, you know, like being more transparent with myself, being more open and honest with myself. Like, even today I was like, I'm not gonna record my vlog, was a sign for me to keep going, because I am seen, I am heard. And if I keep putting myself out there and keep going towards the things that I want, then eventually everything that I want is eventually going to come to me, and it's already mine anyways. This last year, I've just been working on loving myself more, talking to myself better, and listening to my inner self. Intuition, those thoughts, those little nuggets of little noises that you hear in your head is you talking to you. And I'm trying to tune in to her, you know, like, one day, I kid y'all not, I'm finna be hella transparent on this video. About 3 to 4 weeks ago, I was like really in a fucked up mental space, because it's just like so much shit has just happened to the point where I let shit pile up until I explode, you know?
like 3 or 4 weeks ago, I was just like, you know, like I really need to just sit with myself, meditate, just woosah, release, let everything go. I kid y'all not, repetitively meditating every day like I want to, but that's the goal, like to ultimately put an hour or two of meditation in my life, because it helps, it does keep me grounded. But this particular day, I hadn't meditated in a while. Like, it's been sporadic moments where I really feel like I just needed to get in my zen and my mode and just woosah. But this particular day was one of those days where I was just like, you know what, I really need to woosah, because if not, I'm finna spaz on every fucking body. Anybody can get it, they mama, they daddy, they sister, they brother, whoever, you know. I woosah this day, y'all, and I kid y'all not, I had a full-blown conversation with myself in my head, and it wasn't me that was it was me that was talking, but it wasn't me that was talking. It may sound weird because, like, I'm really spiritually inclined and in tune, and even though I'm not the best, or I'm not saying that I'm just, oh, high and mighty and high, no, but what I am saying is, like, I've been tapping into that part of me, and this particular day, I have never had nothing like that happen to me, to where when I meditated, like, literally my higher self was talking to me, and she was just like, girl, you done been through so fucking much. You done did this, X, Y, and Z. You done got through with X, Y, and Z. You done, every time you fell, you came back up harder every time. Every time you lost something, you came back up, came back wanting more, coming harder, just not giving up, just keep playing the field, just like you just never gave up. And she just gave me examples of shit that I've been through in life. And you know, while I'm sitting there meditating, I had to laugh, because it's just like, you right, bitch, like, I am her, like, I do any and everything, anything that I put my mind to, I'm hella creative. If I find an interest in something, like I told y'all, with this, for instance, if I want to do some shit, I'm going to do it, especially if I have an interest in it, and I really want to do it, I am going to do it. She was just reminding me that I'm that bitch, and I have to keep telling myself that, like, Jessica, don't give up on yourself. You are the only one that can save you. Can't nobody else save you, no matter how many people you want to bring with you, no matter how many people that you care about, does not mean that they care about you on that level. And also, you have to live for you. Like, you are living to prove yourself to people, to show them that you loyal, that you care for them, that you ride for them. And a lot of people don't even deserve that shit. A lot of people don't even deserve it, because they don't even give you that in return. I just really had a reality check with myself this year, and then with my job and everything. Like, I prayed for a better job, I got it. And now, you know, I'm seeing myself wanting more. Like, I'm finna go back to school to finish my last few classes. And I'm trying to take this serious, because I don't want to be working a 9-to-5, and especially in this environment and this economy. And I've been pushing this shit for years. Like, I have so many videos, even one of my older videos, if y'all go back to my last videos, like, that had the most views when I was in college back in 2011. Like, back then, I was just posting hella videos, and I got a lot of them private now. But yeah, like, I was really posting, and I didn't give a fuck what the environment was, where I was at. Like, if I wanted to post something, I posted it. If I wanted to do my makeup, even if I wasn't the best, I recorded myself. And I'm trying to get back in that energy, especially now that I'm 31, finna be 32. I've elevated to a whole new level. I feel like I'm not exactly where I want to be, but that's where the 30s and stuff in life just make you feel like you're not where you want to be, but I'm exactly where I need to be. And I'm getting emotional now thinking about it, but I'm exactly where I need to be. And everything that I want is already coming to me, like, and I know it's coming. It's just, everybody has their own time frame. I know mine's is coming, because I have too much to offer, and I've done so much for people, and I've put myself on a back burner for so long just to, you know, but that's neither here nor there. Ultimately, the gist of what I'm saying to y'all is, tune into yourself, love yourself, give yourself more fucking credit, stop showing up for people who don't fucking show up for you, and love those that love you, and communicate with people, talk to people, let people know how you feel, stand on your fucking boundaries, leave all that childish ass shit in 2024 and in 2010s. From the time you popped out your mama pussy, leave that shit where that shit at, and continue to grow and elevate. And this is my message to myself. This is my message to y'all. Just keep fucking going, and don't give up on yourself, and
just love yourself. Even if you're alone, you're never alone, because you always got the man above. And if you believe in any other entity, you got that entity too. You know, like, they all, to me, is a spiritual thing. Like, you are believing in something that makes you want to go harder in yourself. And whatever that may be, I'm not to judge you, but I know I believe in God, and I believe that there is a higher power. I may not go to church every day, but I have God in my heart and my body and my mind and my soul. This is episode 3 of Vlogmas. Thank y'all for tuning in to me do my eyebrows. Thank y'all for just tuning in general. And your girl's going to keep coming with these bangers, y'all. We going strong. We on day 3. I'm going to edit this video and get this shit up by tonight. So thank y'all for tuning in to episode 3. And I'll see y'all tomorrow on 4.